In this video, I wanted to talk about mental health issues. As you may or may not be aware, I'm undertaking a course at the University of Queensland Department of Psychology in terms of overcoming issues and challenges with mental health. It's called Groups for Health at UQ. I'd like to just touch base with actually what I'm doing at the moment in this course, and I'll just show you the booklet itself. It's just a book like this, and it has a series of modules in it that touch base on things to do with the forming of groups, why groups are important, what you get out of the group, what avenues there are in belonging to a group, and to also just map out a bit of a structure, which I have done here on some of the actual preferences of being in the group, you know, where the priorities are and so forth. So I'm just working through this at the moment. I'm still finding that I haven't really overcome a lot of mental health issues. I still find that even though I'm pushing myself to be more sociable and trying to get out there and do more things, I'm still finding that I'm still largely misunderstood as a person. People still do not understand me. I still struggle with friendships, and finding clubs and those sorts of things are still very, very difficult. I'm even looking at joining the UQ Chess Club just to be able to see if there's any possibility to be able to connect with other people and to be able to break down the social isolation that exists and frustration. And believe me, at the moment, I don't know what it is that I feel, I just feel like I'm not really, my body isn't connected with my brain. My brain just feels like it's wounded or something. It feels deflated, it feels overloaded. And I don't know whether it's a meltdown, I don't know whether I'm going insane, I don't know what it is, but it's really, really difficult to deal with. I just find that people are just so rigid, and they're so they just don't understand where I'm coming from. And even when I do something and I feel that I do it well, if just someone would say, just say thank you, or, you know, you're doing a good job or something like that, I just look for that and it doesn't happen. And if it doesn't happen, then I just feel like, why even bother? Why bother to make the effort? And I just feel, and I don't want to go on a whinging crusade, there is a thing I call, which I believe is electronic bullying, and this is actually where sabotage of, where you're involved with machinery or something electrical only occurs when you're there, and furthermore, it's designed by the persons involved to make you feel overwhelmed and stressed to buggery, that you just cannot function, and also withholding the means of being able to move forward in terms of a means of security measures. I mean, this is just, it's just everywhere that it's happening. The deliberate sabotage and the obstruction of allowing people to get ahead and do what they need to do. And it is a problem in Australia. It is a serious problem, and it's even more serious here in Queensland, because it just really is disruptive. It mucks people around, it stresses them out, and this state is just so far behind New South Wales, 50 years behind, because people cannot be progressive here. That's the way I see it, and it is frustrating to be part of that, and that part of this culture, or if you want to call it society, probably more so society. But all I'm stressing is that mental health is a serious, serious condition, and I really hope that if the Prime Minister is watching, or if he's out there, is listening, or his advisors, I really do think he needs to do something about this, because it is an Australia-wide problem, and it is affecting people very significantly, and it has to be ironed out and rooted out of workplaces. It has to also be in education areas, in schools, where there just needs to be ways of overcoming it, and training and being able to understand it, because it's not allowing people to function on their four cylinders, and it's it's really very, very toxic, and it's just not a healthy frame of mind to be in at all. Now, I feel in my own situation, I just feel like I really can't get ahead. I work tremendously hard, and there are people out there that just think I cruise through life on an easy life. I can tell you that behind closed doors, I often have meltdowns. I struggle to get through. I have challenge. I find people don't understand me. I live largely in social isolation. I often do have rare thoughts about suicide. I can see why people actually take their own lives, because they can't see a way out of it. And that is something that people need to all be responsible about, because it's not only me, it's other people. There's also the difficulty in being able to get ahead and having to work tremendously hard on infrastructure that just isn't really designed for you to get ahead, and trying to work through it and trying to deal with a lot of injustices and a lot of discrimination and so forth. And this is across the board. It is very frustrating, and having to deal with a society and a culture that just doesn't understand where you're coming from. It, believe me, it is a constant battle. And we live in a world that is socially based. If you're a person that is not sociable, you're not social, you're more industrious and meticulous, it's a real struggle. People don't understand you. They see you as a threat, and they want to try to control you, or they want to try and get rid of you. And that's how I feel at the moment. And I'm just fine. It's really, really, I really don't know what to do. I don't know whether I should go and seek medical attention, get medical help, try and find whatever there is to be able to deal with it, because it's just constantly, just people don't get it. They don't understand. And, you know, I work very hard in my own life to reach the age of 43, which I am. I still have to work tremendously hard just to be able to function in many aspects of my life. I have to also, I try and write to portray where the difficulties are in being someone who is in my situation. I don't want to use the autism label again, because I feel that it's seen as negative. I really want to just, it'd be good if attitudes would just change and be more accommodating. And it's very, very difficult in certain places because of the fact that there is closed-mindedness, there is narrow-mindedness, there is ignorance, and there is misunderstanding, and what you can only beat your head against a brick wall to try and do something about it. So I really do hope that anybody watching this video can try and understand, because I might appear to you to be like an average person, but believe me, the struggles are far and very, very difficult in between. It's just at times, it's just like, I don't even know what planet I'm on, because I'm trying to navigate through a world that just isn't designed for my way of thinking and functioning, and I have to fight injustices all the time with it, and it is indeed stressful. So I do hope over time that things do get better, but at the moment I'm just coping as best I can, and I do hope that things will change in the future, especially in the areas of mental health. Thank you very much for watching.